Okay, this one is just a short one about ells and duct work and the way they're designed and what makes a good ell for moving air and what makes a poor one. Ells are probably the biggest loser of static pressure and velocity pressure in the ductwork system. And let's kind of look at how the air would normally go through. As the air is passing through, it's going up like this, and a lot of the air is striking the end of the duct right here and is being pushed over. That's not so much the problem. There is some turbulence there, but it's not huge. The problem is down here. When this air comes across like this, you get a lot of turbulence in here, and it makes kind of a big area right here where it doesn't really pass any air through at all. It's just turbulence around there. As it draws, you know, as it bounces off up here, it's going to build up some pressure. It's going to start tending to move the air this way. But this part right here is a part that has a lot of turbulence. And that reduces the effective size of the ductwork by where that turbulence is. You can see the air kind of gets pushed up here and then starts coming down and spreading out again. So let's see if there's anything we can do to make this elbow a little more efficient. Okay, now I've changed this. I've actually, up here, instead of putting a curve up there like I had in the other one, I've made it just square. Down here, I put a gentle curve. This elbow is going to move more air and have less loss in both static and velocity pressure than the other one. So why is it doing that? Let's take a look up here. This is going to be a highly turbulent area. However, because it's up here, now on the other one we had a gentle curve here, but the gentle curve doesn't make a huge difference because this turbulence makes this into kind of a gentle curve. The air just kind of comes up, some of it comes there and starts swirling around, but a lot of it just goes right past and moves out into the ductwork. With a gentle curve here on the inside, the air is going to tend to move this way because of that gentle curve. There's a low pressure area. Whenever air is traveling past an area like this where it gets bigger, there's a little bit of vacuum is pulled in there. Well, it's going to tend to pull it because it's an easy flow. There's no sharp corner here for it to circle around in or anything like that. So it just simply starts to follow the curve. And it more or less does that throughout the whole elbow. So by looking at this, you can see this is not the important part because this pretty much makes makes a round part out of this square corner. But here, reduce our losses for the elbow. Now we can also put turning vanes in here, and I'll see if I can do one that shows turning vanes too. They are the best way to make an elbow and have the lowest loss. Pretty simple one. I hope it makes some sense.